Police say three generations of a family were part of a shoplifting scheme targeting a local business. A grandmother and mother have been arrested for their involvement. WLKY's Drew Douglas has details on the plot from where police say it all happened.
Police say the two suspects had three accomplices from their own family, ages 10, 8, and 3. Their task was to distract the workers at Gaddy Eye Centers as the two women placed designer sunglasses in their purses. They never made it past the front door. These are the suspects investigators say are responsible. Officers arrested 56-year-old Dorothy McLean and her 32-year-old daughter Heather Kessel Thursday afternoon. Police say Kessel's children were part of the plan.
Apparently they used the kids as a distraction to some of the store people that would make some type of commotion.
Police reports say the two women stole at least 10 pairs of glasses. LMPD spokesperson Dwight Mitchell says video surveillance helped verify the chain of events.
They subsequently were stopped by the store manager, which called us, and subsequently they were arrested.
Gaudi Eye Centers values the merchandise at just under $2,500. McLean and Kessel each face one charge of theft.
Well, it's a felony crime for the simple fact the amount of money that it is. Also, the bigger crime here, again, is corrupting kids.
McLean has been found guilty of other shoplifting instances in the past. Kessel has not served jail time for any previous offenses. Mitchell says the women's actions are setting a dangerous example for the youngest members of their family.
They may think that's the way that they are supposed to live life, and unfortunately, the people who have been charged with their care were leading them down the wrong path.
Gaddy Eye Centers has no comment about the incident. Police say the children are now in the care of another family member. From the 7600 block of Shelbyville Road, Drew Douglas, WLKY News.
No charges have been filed for using the children to commit the crime, but police say Child Protective Services is looking into the incident.